So, as you can imagine, entering 2025, you want to be as organized and focused as you can. Well, I've found an application that is a timer-based app that's going to help you to better get into deep focus. Now, it is called Focused Work, and it's available in the link in the description if you're interested. The app is available through Setapp, which is a subscription service for getting, I think, over 240 apps in one. So if you're interested in any of those links, please check them out below. So we're going to show you around this application and why it's an interesting offering. And to start out, what we want to do is give you the pricing. Now, through Setapp, it's available as part of the package, so $9.99 every single month, but obviously you get 240 other apps as part of that. But there is a separate pricing, which I'll show you on screen now, for Focused Work if you want to get it separately. Now, this one is available through iOS and Mac, and it comes as a really interesting application. There are other apps on the market that are timer apps, so if you're comparing these two, do jump over to toolfinder.co to explore the timer apps that we do have as well. So this is the general experience, and what I quite like about it straight away is that you don't just get forced into a setup. So I thought that when you get started with this, it was like you set a timer and you go. But there's actually things called stages. So you can set up a series of stages to basically get you going for the day. So here's the Pomodoro one. So there's a structure to it. Focus, break, focus, break, focus, break. And then obviously when you finish your Pomodoro cycle, if you don't know, you finish after four cycles with a longer break to help you reset. And that's the setup here. You can basically achieve a structure. So it's not just like one time timer, it's a multiple stage timer if you want it to be. So that's the Pomodoro one. I actually created one earlier, because you can create them and I'll show you that in a moment, called Crush It. That's just like a concept. But this is a structure that I created. So you've got to prepare for 2 minutes, you've got focus for 25, break, focus, and then focus back to back as two separate sessions. And you can add intents for each of these. So for example, in this one, I set write one article, but you can set multiple ones as well. Now, before I show you the session editor abilities, you can also add integrations. You can set up shortcuts with other apps as part of the iOS system, block apps when those sessions start. So for example, if you know you're typically bad checking Twitter while you're doing writing articles, then you could set it up per session, if that makes sense, which is much more specific than I've seen of other apps. And that uses the screen time setup with apps and websites. So there's also other abilities with toggle. So you can set up with popular time tracking app toggle if you use it for work. So it can sort of be like a toggle dashboard in terms of you starting sessions and completing them. You can also now, because I've set this up, I can ask Siri, hopefully it didn't kick things off, to start this timer in Focused Work and it will start things off. So there's a nice Siri integration as part of it. So here's what that looks like for me for a session. And I could start this now with this timer. And if I start this, it prompts me, which you can set up in the session editor, which I'll do in a moment, what your goal is. So for example, you can say complete 3 articles and I could start the timer. And as you can see, preparing for it might be grabbing the things you need, your headphones, your items, I don't know what it be, but this is a nice preparation experience. Now, if I want to skip a stage just for an example, it's going to start now on that first focused zone. So I'm now in this zone here. There is a timer in the menu bar for the Mac version. You can set sound on or off to have the ding pop up when you're going through stages. And up here, there's a scratch pad. I thought it was a calendar entry where it tags it in your calendar, but it's a scratch pad allowing you just to write a few notes. Over here, you can also set up some integrations while you're doing that and block websites if you haven't preset that, which is quite nice. And here you can see your session objective and your focus goal. So the session goal is that collective session. Focus goal is each one's, which is quite nice. So while that's going on, I'm just going to show you the reporting side of stuff. So I created one earlier and it's got loads of insight into how your daily goals can be achieved, like how many focus sessions you did. And at the end of each session, which I didn't do, you can set a productivity rating based on it and write some notes, which is quite cool. So you can have and see all of your sessions here, and you can pin ones as your favorite one, but this is the editor. So here I can go into detail on what's typical structure that I like. So you can set a standard one, a flexible one, a flow modoro. I have no idea what that is. I think it's where you get a break after you focus for periods of time. Honestly, I'm not even going to touch that. Trying a new concept during the video review. But you can add more, so I can add more focus, more breaks. It's quite easy to actually create it. And then here, you've got the ability to review the structure before you start and ask the goals. You can set a default goal if it's something that you routinely do, like that complete 3 articles. I can set up an exact workflow that works best for it. And you can set up reminders, descriptions, deep links for certain apps as well. So for example, if you want to start a session and automatically open Obsidian for starting to write, you can do that through the deep linking abilities. There's also integrations. So here, I could add an integration for blocking a particular website. In this case, it could be like block twitter.com or x.com it is now. And now that website, I believe that I added it there. There we go. And now that website is going to be blocked when I do that, and I can put it as Twitter and save it. So now that is all set up. During that period of time, I will not be available to do it. So that's all the details in terms of getting it started, which is quite cool. Now what I'm going to do is you can also choose an icon and rename it. So it's not just that ant. I don't know why it came up with the ant, but maybe I had some sort of default. It automatically allocates a emoji. But what's quite cool is on this left-hand side, I can do this. I can go back to the focus session and I can skip stages if I want to. What's nice as well is you get the end time, which is quite cool. So that's a nice addition. So all in all, this app is an interesting one. It allows you to set up that flow stages. And for those who don't know, oh, I didn't see that before, it goes into a focus state when you've got that, which is quite nice. It's part of something called the Benson methodology that we created. The system that we designed is like to have these set up in terms of states for you, like large, medium, small. It's called a workflow. And we think it's a good way for you to embrace the energy levels you have across the day. For example, like you start the day sometimes with loads of energy. I typically do have like my most energy between 9 and 11. Then it just drops off for lunch, comes back a little bit in the afternoon, but backs off again. You could create an energy map based on this. So I think it's a really interesting app for that. And one that I think for deep work, for that timer experience is much better. Actually, I didn't think it would be as good as this compared to other apps like Session. Session does an amazing detail when reporting, but this does a lot better on the terms of the workflow templatizing of this stage, if that makes sense. So try it out yourself. Find it in the link in the description. This is obviously my initial review of it. It's seemingly well built. And if you've already got a toolkit set up, it could be a good one to snap onto the back of that. So thank you so much for stopping by in today's video. If you want to check out more apps like this, you can go over to toolfinder.co and explore plenty more. And you can find it linked in the description below. Thank you so much for stopping by. Please do subscribe to this YouTube channel if you're interested in exploring more applications, picking the best ones for you, because we'll help you find that. It was Francesco D'Alessio, and I'll catch you in another video. Cheerio for now.